Hello and Namaste everyone. I am Kamal Shrestha and I am here with Aditi Babara. We are here to present our paper on hostility detection in online Hindi-English code mix conversations at the 14th ACM Web Science Conference. So starting with the outline of the presentation, we'll first talk about the motivation behind the paper followed by the problem statement. Then once we have a clear problem to work on, we will talk about the proposed model and the necessary experimental setups. Finally, we will discuss on the results obtained, followed by a short ablation study. Summing up, we will conclude by talking about the key contributions and the future scopes of the paper. So, starting with the introduction, hostility detection in English text is a well-studied domain, so there are a number of patents available to us. On top of the same, we add some low-resource language text like Hindi to give it a multilingual setup, as text in tools that we intend to work on can be in multiple languages as well. This combined text with high and low resource language is called a code mix data. Social media platforms like Twitter contains a hierarchy of conversational threads as seen in the comments sections of the newsfeed. So we work on the same structure with tweets, comments and replies called as the hierarchical code mix conversational data. Finally, we intend to find hostile content present in this hierarchical code mix conversational data in this paper. The hierarchy of the data is as shown in the figures. We can see that there are n number of tweets, each tweet containing n number of comments, and each comment containing k number of replies, with each reply containing multiple other replies as well. Here, n and k varies with the tweet and comments correspondingly. So now the problem statement is to determine whether a given code mixed text, that is post or comment or reply, is non-head offensive none or head and offensive HOF. But it is crucial to understand that the classification of a code mixed text is more dependent on the previous context and it not just on its own as a text, as the text can be of positive sentiment standalone but might actually be in support of an offensive statement. For example, as you can see in the figure on the right, the comment "a mine" is itself not hit an offensive but supports the tweet that is actually hit an offensive. Hence, the comment should also be classified as hit an offensive. We refer to a number of papers that talk about the hostility detection problem in low resource languages with a multilingual setups and code mix conversations. Out of them, the above two resembled closely with our problem statement we are trying to solve. Talking about the proposed model, the major intuition behind the proposed model is to capture the hierarchy of the conversational thread so as to extract the context selectively based on the input text. We have four distinct steps, the first one being to flatten out the hierarchy with appropriate concatenations and separation of tokens. Secondly, we will extract contextual representations for corresponding texts. Then, we will combine the context into smaller dimensions to create a combined representations. Finally, this combined representations of context is appended to the text to be classified and passed to a classification head to get the logics and eventually predictions. Now, we will explain the structure more formally. Initially, the post, comment and the replies are separated. Since the post is the start of any thread, it doesn't have any prior context to it. For a comment, prior context is the post only. And whereas for a reply, prior context might be its previous replies if there are any, and its corresponding comments. For each post, comment and reply, its context is defined as mentioned here. The process is simple. We obtain the contextual representations of the comment, post and reply. If the input is only post, we directly pass it to the classification head to get the predictions. If the input is comment, we concatenate the post earlier and pass the concatenated representations to the classification head. Whereas, if the input is reply, we concatenate the context and the post, project it to a smaller dimension, then followed by the concatenation of the reply to pass it through the classification head and get the predictions. So for this experimental setup, I would like to call Aditi Babara to continue on with the presentation.
Having a model setup, we'll now look into experimental setup for training. We employed a number of baselines to validate our proposed model. CodeMix XLMR on the left was picked up from a reference paper working on a similar problem statement. The baseline on the right follows a naive additive concatenation of post with its comments and replies in a sequential manner as they are posted. The combined text is passed through a pre-trained transformer model for embeddings and a classification head for predictions. But with a weighted context baseline, the concatenation of embedding is not naive and simple addition. The intuition here is not to prioritize context and the actual text equally, like before. So the text and the text to be classified are weighed differently using lambda 1 and lambda 2 that are learned during the training itself. Finally, for our last baseline, we weighed the previous context based on similarity measure of cosine distance with the text to be classified. Like before, the weighted embeddings are passed through classification head to get the predictions. So with this, we have all our baselines ready. Not just the baselines, we have the training and testing sets and matrix of evaluation. A total of 62 different conversational threads were divided with a ratio of 60-40 into training and testing conversations. The pie chart on the left shows the number of HOF and none labeled instances in the entire data, which is further divided into HOF and none on right for each train and test set. And for evaluations of the model, we'll be using accuracy and FN score as matrices. With the experimental setup completed, we train and test the hierarchical model to obtain the results. These results are analyzed in this section. We performed various experiments under different settings comparing our baselines with proposed models. Method indicates the pre-trained model used to obtain representations. We did direct fine-tuning and used different machine learning models like random forest, logistic regression, XGBoost, voting classifier for classification. The table clearly shows that proposed model performed better than baselines in terms of accuracy and FN score. We performed live analysis to see model's attention while predicting labels. The words in the orange color are words that are viewed as HOF by the model, and the words in the blue are viewed as neutral or positive. The table entry shows how attention for different words influence the prediction. A specific instance is shown in the next slide. The instance shows that model is giving a positive score for the word best, whereas it is giving and then bhakts a negative score. The overall prediction for label of a sentence is cumulative effect of each word score. Next, we also performed ablation study. We tried to remove layers from the proposed model and then we tried to remove content from the model. The result shows that each component in the model architecture is important to perform a better prediction. Finally, to conclude, we conclude by saying that we proposed a hierarchical neural network model for conversational CodeMix dataset that exploits inherent hierarchical structure of data and also selectively extracts the relevant context for a given address. In future scope, the work can be extended for multiple languages and different social media platforms. Here are some of the references for the paper understanding. Thank you for your time. Please feel free to ask me any questions you have or raise any issues in the provided GitHub link.